But at this stage, may I just say that we're delighted to welcome Lord Snowdon. Very good to see you indeed. And I know, for example, that you didn't set out to be a photographer. In fact, it was architecture that you originally were studying at university. So how did it come about that you made the switch?
I didn't finish my portfolio. It was as simple as that. And anyway, I was going to be an architect. And you see, in those days, to be a photographer was quite a lowly profession. And it's now got rather too highfalutin, in my opinion. it's got too grand. The whole point about taking photographs, the photograph's important and the subject's important. But the person who takes them should be completely unseen, and I shouldn't be here at all.
Well, I'm very glad you are. But I suppose if you compare architecture and photography, it's all to do with the eye anyway, how you perceive, isn't it?
Yes, but there are two kinds of types, really. I mean, the two photographers I admire most, on the one hand, is somebody called Cartier-Bresson, who's arguably the most famous photojournalist that's ever been. And at the age of 91, he's still going strong and is a great friend. He's wonderful and he's just not seen. I think that on the other end of the scale is Irving Penn, a great American photographer, who does beautifully posed, stylish pictures, which are wonderful. And I admire them both enormously.
Yes, I want to talk about the very early theatre stuff just for a moment, because I suppose on one hand you can say, from a photographer's point of view, it's wonderful to have the access to all these great people to photograph. But how did you make that entree, if you like, into the theatre world?
Well, I mean, it was entirely thanks to my uncle, Oliver Messel, who was a theatre designer, arguably the greatest in the sort of 30s, 40s, 50s and 60s. And I adored him. And so he knew all the great people like Alec Guinness and Olivier. And it was entirely thanks to him that I started doing those kind of theatre pictures. And then eventually I worked down in a basement just around the corner here in Shaftesbury Avenue with somebody called David Sim. But the pictures, what I was trying to do then was to try and get away from the stylized photographs and do pictures that were more like reportage and enlarge them to a huge size, because I saw it as my job to get people off the bus, to go and buy a ticket for the theatre. It's as simple as that. It was trying to get most of the photographs in the theatre at that time were taken by two wonderful people. One person called Angus McBain, who was a great photographer, and another person called Houston Rogers. And their pictures were very stylish. And I'm afraid I came in with just very small equipment, no lights, and the directors liked it because it took less time. I mean, before that, you usually have to spend a day down. It was seemingly always in Bournemouth.
But also, it was a chance, actually, to see people more in a casual frame of mind, or those lovely off moments in terms of the stage. Has it been very difficult for you to decide which photographs you're going to put into this exhibition? Because it's a very important exhibition.
Well, yes, unfortunately, it's been called a retrospective, which I think is a frightfully pompous word and silly. I'd much rather it was called an obituary, really.
Oh, no.
But I've been helped enormously by two people. Robin Muir, who's at this moment hanging the things, and Ray Watkins, who's done the layout for the book. They've been invaluable. And they've chosen what to put in and what to leave out.
Mm. And just taken the onus away from you slightly.
We were scraping the bottom of the barrel to find anything to go in. It was worthwhile, but
the only other thing I would like to say is that I think all of us admire very much your photojournalistic work, because last year, for example, I know you did a bit of project abroad on polio, for example. But, you know, you're very focused on that, aren't you, on doing something for the disabled or the needy?
Well, it's very much part of my life, yes. And if, as a photographer, we can achieve certain things to break down the barriers and not to be of voyeurs, not to expose people to any kind of photographic exercise, but to try to make for more understanding, to show a bit of love. And I've done them at the end of the exhibition in a very dark room, very simply lit. It's very undramatic. No gimmicks. But hopefully people will go out thinking about the less fortunate in our society at the moment. And don't forget, there are thousands of people, and
Absolutely.
We are incredibly lucky.
Yes. Well, I were very much looking forward to seeing the exhibition. I'd like to thank you very much indeed for joining us today. Lord Snowdon. Thank you very much.